Right, Aki Kareem, BBTV, I'm delighted to be joined by Mark Bateson, who is, you know, promoter, manager, you know, put on great shows in Leeds at Elland Road, keep a lot of fighters active. Unfortunately, we're in this situation where small hold promoters in particular, small and medium promoters have been affected by the situation. Can you just tell us a little bit about how it's affected you, Mark, with your shows and your stable?
Yeah, it's affected us massively, to be honest with you. I suppose it's not only the boxers and the promoters, it's your timekeepers, your referees, your MCs, whips, timekeepers, the list goes on, you know. So I think it's affected just about everybody in the boxing business, except the people, that's the promoters that's got television. I don't think they've really suffered. They've suffered a bit, but not like we have. You know, so it's a shame because I've got some cracking lads coming through who'd have made a big impact in 2020, and that's all sort of like being put on the shelf now. And it's sad for the lads to motivate themselves when they haven't got a date. I think I've spoilt my boxers in a way, the ones I promote, because they're never waiting on a date. Every time they box, I will have another date for them penciled in, so they can build up to that, and they're just ticking over now, you know. I've had phone calls from Matchroom, Queensbury Promotions, for fights, for my lads, but 2 weeks' notice, 7 days' notice, as a manager, promoter and trainer, I want to look after my lads, and it's just not long enough, and I keep saying to them, look, if you want any of my lads to fight any of yours, give me at least six weeks, 7 weeks, you know. We need that just to lose the weight. Never mind get 100% fit. And he's fit and he's boxing fit, which are two different things entirely, you know. My lads are ticking over. They're all in the gym, but they won't be ready in 2 weeks. You know, they're not all dieting and thinking, oh, I've got to keep my weight down, I've got to keep my weight down. Don't get me wrong, we've just got over Christmas and New Year. And a lot of them would have put a lot of weight on, you know. But most of them have trained all through the Christmas period. So it has affected the lads a lot.
Yeah, yeah. I mean, I've been to some of your shows. They're brilliant shows. You get loads of people there. You have a deep card with lots of, you're giving opportunities to lots of young prospects and talent. You know, from your perspective, is it just a massive shame as well that you can't get these talented fighters out? And have you seen any of them, you know, how they cope with it as well from their side, the fighters?
They've struggled, to be honest with you. You know, it's hard to motivate when you haven't got a date. You know, we don't know how long this is going to last, really, do we? You know, like, we've got these vaccines now. How long is it going to be before there's going to be actually small old promotions where we're going to have a crowd? Without the crowd, we can't put the show on. You know, I know there's been certain people that's put shows on who's got a good sponsor, like Clifton Mitchell put a show on in Liverpool, and it costs about 40-odd grand, you know, with getting the vaccine, well, getting the test, you know, COVID test, and promoters can't afford to do that. You know, and the boxers, like, I know down on that show, the boxers have to pay for the opponents and pay for the COVID test. It still costs a promoter fortunes. So you're in the game, you've been in the game a long time, you're quite knowledgeable. I'll ask you the question, when do you think boxing will get back to normality?
That's a good question, Mark. I mean, you know, it changes every month. People are pushing it back. I think for small or boxing, I'm hoping by the summer, to be honest, Mark. But you've mentioned there something important, because people have said, well, why don't they just put on small or promoters, put on shows behind closed doors? But you've just outlined there perfectly. It's not feasible, is it, for a small or promoter to do it?
No, it's impossible. It's impossible. You know, as much as I'd love to, I know that my house would be up for sale, you know, a couple of weeks after. But no, I I pulled my hair out, thinking of words. How can we do it? How can we get it? And even I've got one or two good sponsors, but I couldn't go to them and ask for 30K, you know, to put in. I'm just, it's like, look at Dennis Hobson. Great idea, you know. I had the boxing show in a car park. People were paying £300 a car, four people per car. And I think he did the business there. You've got to take it off to him. Massive, massive risk, and it paid off for him.
Yeah, I watched the Hangar 31 show, I think it was, in the Clifton Mitchell show. I watched the car park show. They were good. They were innovative. They tried to do something different. But again, it boils down to the fact that, you know, it's not an endless money pot, is it? And now without a TV deal, that's the problem, without the TV deal. Now, you mentioned fighters getting caught, you know, you've been getting calls, but at short notice. That's also a little bit unfair, isn't it, on the fighters? Because it's almost like...
It is really, you know, but fighters, and a lot of them would take a fight, you know, at short notice if they're training. But I don't think most of them fighters that are fighting on Matchroom shows and that are 100%. You know, don't get me wrong, some are, if the brand and they said, right, well, your lad fight so-and-so on such a day, 8 weeks from now, it's a 50-50 fight. But when they're coming in at a week's notice, 2 weeks' notice, it's just, that's the first thing I'm going to do. I won't even tell me fighters, nah, you know, give me at least 6 weeks and then we've probably got a fight.
I mean, you're always...
That's not sort of like being funny with them. It's about looking after my lads. You know, it's all about looking after them. You know, they're used to sort of like... And like when they box, don't get me wrong, there's one or two lads coming out short notice from their box on my shows. But a lot of them, like I've got my matchmaker, Mick Marsden, and he gets them all sorted, like at least 5 weeks, they're all matched up, you know, before the show. But there's times where they do fall off at last minute and then we've got to get someone in. And I suppose that happens with Matchroom and that, but to look after your fighters, I just go, it's a no-goer.
You know, your own son in your stable, Jack, he's a really talented prospect. And congratulations to him, by the way, on his engagement. But, he of course, is a young fighter who's, you know, just wants to get out all the time. I know what he's like. He just wants to fight, doesn't he? How have you sort of managed his expectations? And do you think this is going to be an era where a lot of young prospects really need to be very, very mentally strong, because otherwise they could end up turning to a different job?
Yeah, without a doubt. I think there's going to be a lot of the older end who are in their 30s, early 30s, who think I've got 2 good years at it, who are probably going to retire now. You know, it's finished their careers a lot earlier than they expected, you know, like... It's really, I'm sort of like, you know, it's so destroying to think, oh, I've got one more good year, you know, and then this has happened. It's finished them off, really. And I feel sorry for the amateurs. You know, I heard that the government invested £300 million into amateur sport, but boxing weren't in there.
Nothing for boxing. Disgraceful.
Scandalous, you know. And boxing does keep kids off the streets. You know, in deprived areas, that's what they look up to, you know, like, oh, and I've seen it with all the years I've been in the gym, you know, young kids, and they've had troublesome backgrounds, they've come in, they've trained hard, and they're getting to championships, and they're in there every night training hard, you know, taking them off the street, and the government's gone, you know, I just can't get my head around it. And again, that's why I've heard that they're queuing up, they're all wanting to turn pro, but you're in the same boat, you're still not going to box, you know, until this is over.
You know, so, have you heard anything yourself about when you potentially, have you earmarked a date in your head when you're thinking this month is when I'm going to start trying to put some plans together, or is it just up in the air?
Well, I put some plans together for November last year. I'm going to say this year, but I put November, I had it penciled in. I had 2 shows, Friday and Saturday, booked in at Ellen Road. And then I thought, yeah, I think it'll come back round about then, you know, but it didn't. So now And the thing is, I'm telling my lads, look, November, you know, get yourself fit. I think this is when it's all going to change. And I'm upset for them because I'm thinking, I'm telling them to get fit. I think that, and then I'm phoning them saying, look, it's not going to happen, you know. And I just don't know when I can honestly turn around with hand on heart and say, right, I'm going to book a date and hopefully that'll be it. I'm just, until we know what's what, I'll be one of the first, you know, as soon as I turn around and go, right, crowds are back. But I think it'll come in slowly as well. I think that the crowds will come back, but only a percentage of the crowd. Again, it depends how big your venue is to make it pay. Yeah. Without people paying on the door and selling tickets, small old promoters are ghosts.
Yeah, yeah. And Mark, I know boxing is such a big part of your life. It's a passion, it's a business, it's everything. Yeah. How's it, you know, personally speaking, as a well-known promoter who you know is like a bit of a lifeblood for your region, how has it personally affected you?
Well, it's affected me a lot, really, you know, because I'm just, it's soul destroying for me. I feel like I'm training the lads, they're ticking over. What am I training them for, you know, until this is over, you know? I have struggled a bit, to be quite honest with you. It's, but the good thing is, all my boxers are quite intelligent and they understand, you know, they understand, same as me, that it's not my fault, you know, it's nobody's fault, there's a pandemic and it's out there and we can only go by the government rules. And we all want to get back. It's not just me, you know what I mean? There's plenty of promoters up and down the country like Steve Woods, Carl Greaves, the list goes on, you know what I mean? Steffi Bull, they're all biting at the bit to get out there. But and we're all in the same boat.
Yeah, and I really wish my very best to all of you because it's a hard situation. Mark, have you got a message for anyone else who's in your situation, a promoter like some of the guys you mentioned, they're all top guys, any fighters that are really struggling at the minute with it all? Have you got a message for them of like, or some advice for them about how to sort of get through this period?
Just stay strong, keep positive. That's all you can do. You know, hopefully it'll come back sooner than we think. Now they've got these vaccines that are flying about. Let's hope that should change, you know, everything now, and we should be getting back on board, you know. That's all I can say. Yes, stay strong, stay active, keep fit, stay in the gym, and that's all you can do.
Well, Mark, I really hope the situation changes. I really appreciate you spending time with me and talking to me about this. And, you know, please keep in touch. And when you're ready to go, let us know. And, we you know, anything we can do to help
you. I will, yeah. Definitely get you up, yeah. Definitely. As soon as I do, you'll be first to know.
Cheers, Mark. Really appreciate your time. All the best. Enjoy the rest of the day.
Yeah.
And we'll catch up again soon, Mark. Cheers.
Cheers. Thanks.
Thank you, mate. Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.